I saw a very bright light in the southern gable of the chapel. I never saw, I thought, so brilliant a light before. It appeared high up in the air, above and around the chapel gable.
Judith Campbell, 22. Mary Byrne called at my house around 8 o'clock and asked me to come up and see the great sight of the chapel. I ran up with her to the place and saw three figures. I was amazed.
Bridget Trench, 74. I went immediately to kiss, as I thought, the feet of the Virgin Mary. But I felt nothing in the embrace but the wall, and I wondered why I could not feel with my hands the figure which I had so plainly and distinctly seen.
John Durkin, 24. I went out with the others to see the vision that Dominic Byrne came to tell us of. I saw the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Joseph, and St. John. There was a mitre on St. John's head, nearly like that a bishop wears.
I was staying at my grandmother's house, and I followed her and my aunts and uncle to the chapel. I saw the figures of the Blessed Virgin and that of St. Joseph and St. John.
Patrick Byrne, 16. Dominic Byrne Jr. came to my house and said that he had seen the biggest sight that ever he witnessed in his life. I saw the figures clearly, fully and distinctly, the Blessed Virgin, St. John, and that of a bishop.
Mrs. Hugh Flackley, Bridget, 44. I was passing by the Chapel of Knock, and beyond most clearly and distinctly, the figure of Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Joseph, and that of St. John the Evangelist.
Patrick Hill, 11. I live in Claremorris and was visiting my aunt in Knock. On that day, I was drawn home to her from the bog. I followed with the others to the chapel gable, where we immediately saw the lights. Our Lady wore a brilliant crown and on it a beautiful rose of a golden brightness. I stayed for an hour and a half in the pouring rain.
Dominic Byrne, Sr., 36. My cousin Dominic Byrne came to see us about 8 o'clock and called me to go and see the vision. That night was dark and raining, and yet not one drop of rain fell upon the vision.
Margaret Byrne, 21. My niece Catherine Murray called me out to see the Blessed Virgin and the other saints standing at the south gable of the chapel. There I beheld the Blessed Virgin with a bright crown on her head, St. Joseph to her right, and St. John the Evangelist to her left, holding in his left hand, a book of the Gospels and his right hand raised as if preaching to the people who stood before him.
My friend Patrick Hill lifted me up to see the beautiful images.
Ave, Maria. hair.
I have a problem with what do you sing, my brother?
Paul, your hair must be destroyed.
Absolutely.
Rude. Rude. This
weather,
huh?
Do you want to join yourselves?
Are you ready for Pope Francis to get here?
Yeah!
Yeah. He's on his way. He's in the air somewhere between Dublin and Knock. Hopefully he'll get here soon. I think we need to be ready for him when he gets here. I think we need to practice our Knock welcome and make sure that we're ready for him to give him the best welcome he got in Ireland so far.
Absolutely. I think we really need to give him a West of Ireland welcome.
I think
big
so.
Time.
I think so.
It's actually amazing. The zones, you can see from here, the zones have started to fill up an awful lot. I think we could have a roaring competition and see
Sounds
which...
Sounds like a good idea,
what do you think?
Yes? Yeah. The blue zone are up for it anyway.
The blue zone are ready.
What about the red zone back there? I think they're asleep. Oh no, they're there.
We can't hear you. Can you go any louder? Very good.
Excellent. What about the yellow zone over here? Let's hear you.
Oh, wow,
there's great crowds going over there, and there's great flag waving as well. What about the blue zone again? You're going to sleep, I think.
We'll try all three zones together and see if we can.
All three zones. We need to do this good. Here we go, Paul. Give them a count in.
3, 2, 1.
Go!
Wow. That's a good West of Ireland noise.
Excellent.
Absolutely.
Excellent. So as soon as we know that Pope Francis is due to arrive in Knock, we'll let you know. We're keeping an eye on the screens and the feed here. We might get our wonderful musicians over in the corner there to play us another couple of tunes while we wait. Get the clapping going, have a little bit of fun in your chorales, and we'll keep you updated as to where Pope Francis is and when he's due to arrive in Knock.
Thank you.
Well, we have images from the airport. It looks a bit misty up there. But I think we saw a plane land, did we, Paul?
Yeah, it looks
I think
he's
he must
on
be
the way.
Here. He's nearly here, everybody.
The Holy Father has arrived to County Mayo.
So when we know more, we'll keep telling you. We'll keep telling you as we're going along. Don't forget to keep an eye on the screens for everything. So, nothing yet, but just go ahead, Paul.
And as you can see, you will see on the screens that there's a greeting party of Archbishop Michael Leary and the Western bishops will greet the Holy Father. We've also, as you can see there on the screen right now, a load of children from the five local primary schools. Thanks be to God, they have some umbrellas there, so hopefully they'll be staying dry. But they're the greeting party that will welcome the Holy Father at the airport.
It's a great opportunity, isn't it, for all the children of the area to be involved in something like this. It's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. There's some people there, we don't know who they are, but give them a wave anyway.
Give them a wave. Yeah.
So we might get our minstrels in the corner to play us another tune, will we, to get us in the mood? Clap into this. Come on.
Come on, I see hands in the air. Let's clap our hands. Our flags. Thank you.
You see yourself on the screen, give a big wave. So preparations are still being made here with the paint and the desktop, as you can see. If you're watching the footage of Dublin yesterday, nothing happened.
So you can see the welcoming party already. think everybody was singing, Una. Was everybody singing?
Can we just sing it again? Will you give it a good sing this time? Let's try with the chorus again. Golden Road.
Excellent, much better. That sounds absolutely excellent. Well done, everybody. It's not long now.
You'll be here very soon.
Can you answer him? Tell him yes. Call him.
Thank you. Good morning. Cari fratelli e sorelle, sono contento di essere qui con voi. Sono contento di essere con voi nella casa della Madonna. E rendo grazie a Dio per l'opportunità di visitare nel contesto dell'incontro mondiale delle famiglie questo santuario così caro al popolo irlandese. Ringrazio l'arcivescovo Neary e il rettore Padre Gibbons per il loro cordiale benvenuto. Nella Cappella dell'Apparizione ho affidato all'amorevole intercessione della Madonna tutte le famiglie del mondo, in modo speciale le vostre famiglie, le famiglie irlandesi. Maria, nostra madre, conosce le gioie e le fatiche che si sperimentano in ogni casa. Tenendole nel suo cuore immacolato, le presenta con amore al trono del suo figlio. Al ricordo della mia visita, ho portato in dono un rosario. So quanto è importante in questo paese la tradizione del rosario familiare. Mi raccomando, continuate con questa tradizione. Quanti cuori di padri, madri e figli hanno attinto consolazione e forza nel corso degli anni meditando sulla partecipazione della Madonna ai misteri gaudiosi, luminosi, dolorosi e gloriosi della vita di Cristo. Maria è madre. Maria è nostra madre. È anche la madre della Chiesa ed è a lei che affidiamo oggi il cammino del popolo fedele di Dio in questa isola d'Esmeraldo. Chiediamo che le famiglie siano sostenute nel loro impegno di diffondere il regno di Cristo e di prendersi cura degli ultimi tra i nostri fratelli e sorelle. Fra i venti e le tempeste che imperversano sui nostri tempi, siano le famiglie baluardi di fede e di bontà che, secondo le migliori tradizioni della nazione, resistono a tutto ciò che vorrebbe sminuire la dignità dell'uomo e della donna, creati a immagine di Dio e chiamati al sublime destino della vita eterna. La Madonna guardi con misericordia tutti i membri sofferenti della famiglia del suo figlio. Pregando davanti alla sua statua, le ho presentato in particolare tutti i sopravvissuti vittime di abusi da parte di membri della Chiesa in Irlanda. Nessuno di noi può esimersi dal commuoversi per le storie dei minori che hanno patito abusi, che sono stati derubati dell'innocenza o che sono stati allontanati dalle mamme e abbandonati allo sfregio di dolorosi ricordi.
Abandoned and left with painful memories.
Questa piaga aperta
this open wound
si sfida ad essere
us to be
fermi e decisi nella ricerca della verità e della giustizia. Imploro il perdono del Signore per questi peccati,
sins,
per lo scandalo e il tradimento avvertiti da tanti nella famiglia
so
di Dio. Chiedo alla nostra Madre Beata di intercedere per tutte le persone sopravvissute di abusi di qualsiasi tipo e di confermare ogni membro della famiglia cristiana nel risoluto proposito di non permettere mai più che queste situazioni accadano. E anche di intercedere per tutti noi,
an intercession for all of us,
perché possiamo procedere sempre con giustizia,
so that we could proceed following justice,
e riparare in quanto di noi dipenda tanta violenza.
As far as we are concerned, the damage done.
Il mio pellegrinaggio a Knock,
my pilgrimage to Knock,
permette anche di rivolgere un cordiale saluto all'amata gente dell'Irlanda del Nord.
Beloved people of Northern Ireland.
Sebbene il mio viaggio per l'incontro mondiale delle famiglie non includa una visita al nord, vi assicuro il mio affetto e la mia vicinanza nella preghiera. Chiedo alla Madonna di sostenere tutti i membri della famiglia irlandese perché perseverino come fratelli e sorelle nell'opera di riconciliazione. Con gratitudine per i progressi ecumenici e per la significativa crescita di amicizia e collaborazione tra le comunità cristiane, prego perché tutti i discepoli di Cristo portino avanti con costanza gli sforzi per far progredire il processo di pace e costruire una società armoniosa e giusta per i figli di oggi, siano cristiani, siano musulmani, siano ebrei, siano di qualsiasi fede, figli dell'Irlanda.
The sons and daughters of Ireland.
Ed ora, con queste intenzioni e con tutte quelle che portiamo nel cuore, rivolgiamoci alla Beata Vergine Maria con la preghiera dell'Angelus. Angelus Domini, nunc habet Mariae. Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria.
Ecce ancilla Domini. Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus. Il verbum caro factum est. Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus. Ora pro nobis Santa Dei Genitris. Gratiam tuam quesumus, Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, ut angelo nunciante, Christi fili tui incarnazione coniovium, per passionem eius et crucem, a resurrezione gloriam perducamur, per eundem Christum Dominum nostrum. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto. Pro fidelibus defuntis, requiem aeternam donei Domine. Requiescant in pace. Sit nomen Domini benedictum. Editorium nostrum in nomine Domini. Benedica vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen. Amen. Desidero rivolgere uno speciale saluto.
I offer a special greeting
agli uomini e alle donne che sono in carcere in questo paese.
Who are in prison.
Ringraziare in particolare quanti da loro mi hanno scritto avendo saputo che sarei venuto in Irlanda. Vorrei dirvi vi sono vicino, molto vicino.
I assure you and your families that I am very close to you.
Assicuro a voi e ai vostri familiari la mia vicinanza e la mia preghiera. Maria, Madre di Misericordia, vegli su di voi e vi rafforzi nella fede e nella speranza.
Grazie.
Thank you. Wow, what a moment. What a moment. I hope you all enjoyed that as much as I have. That was an absolutely unbelievable experience. And well done to everybody involved for making such a wonderful occasion possible. In particular, we have to really say a huge thank you to Father Richard Gibbons, the parish priest and rector of Knock Shrine. We are now entering the third section of our gathering here this morning. And really, we have so much to be thankful for. And the word Eucharist, as we know, means thanksgiving. So we remain where we are, and we spend some time in giving thanks. Giving thanks for the gift of family. Giving thanks for the gift of all gathered here. The volunteers are to make their way towards their positions for Mass. And as they do so, I would ask you to please give a huge round of applause to our many volunteers who have helped us. In relation to Eucharistic ministers, please know that the Eucharistic ministers will make their way towards your zone. So don't worry too much, we will make our way around the grounds of the shrine. They will have white umbrellas. For those who are gluten-free or celiac, there will be a red umbrella at the different corrals that you will be able to see from a distance. So we ask you to take your seats here at the front. And we will begin to practice the songs for Mass. I again ask people in the very front section to please pick their seats. Thank you very much. So we're going to go through some hymns for Mass.